1 Corinthians 1:27. God chose the foolish of the world to shame the wise. God chose the weak to shame the strong. Don't understand that scripture. Ask God for his wisdom before you try to go by your own understanding, because you're going to be wrong. Now, that was because a lot of people that's not called right now keep speculating about those who are called. And I'm talking about those who are truly called. I'm not talking about worldly church folk. No, we're not talking about the lukewarmers. I'm talking about the true church of God, which are spread out. They're secluded. They are a place where God needs them to be. Set apart ones. We are set apart right now for a reason. We are not right now together as one. We won't be together as one until the new kingdom comes. When the new kingdom comes, then we'll be one big family. We'll be one big church. But right now, we're secluded. The true church of God is spread it out where he needs them to be for his spiritual purpose, for his purpose. Now, people, you have to understand, for those who are not called, you have to understand his chosen ones. God did not choose us to become punks. We are not punks. We are not scaredy cats. We are not weak individuals. That's why we're hated, if anything. We're hated because we're strong individuals. I'm trying to get people to understand something about being chosen. When we're chosen, if you don't understand, if you're chosen, you're not at that level where you understand your calling right now. Let me tell you something. It's people out there that's not called, which meaning also not saved. People need to understand that the chosen one means being saved. God has called you out. And he has saved you, meaning receive salvation to serve him. That's why he gave you the mysteries. So you would know the depths of the good news and be able to live it and teach it. Now, with that saying, you have people who don't understand that. And they look at individuals as called out ones as some type of weak, lame people of the world. And so that's the reason why Satan muppets his henchmen, people. He muppets them to aggravate us, send us a provocation, make us think twice about what we used to be in the past. See, we got much respect of the world, from the world. We got respect when we was this bad person of Satan. We was like bad people of the world going around killing people. I'm not saying I'd kill. I'm just giving an example. I'm trying to get y'all to understand me. You this individual who used to go around killing people and doing all this this nonchalant nonsense, living this mischievous lifestyle, being a knucklehead for Satan of the world. People of the world respect people who live this evil lifestyle more than if they was to come across a child of God. Why? Because people of the world who don't have understanding of the scriptures look at it, which is also being guided mentally, emotionally by Satan. It's embedded in their brain to look at it the opposite way. Good is evil, good is boring, good is sad, good is lame, nothing. You can treat it and they won't do nothing. They can't do nothing. They're boring. They're nothing, whatever. But on the other hand, if you're serving Satan and you're doing all these exciting things of the world, you're killing, you're dressing nice and you're egoistic and you're stunning, you're flung, you want these things that make the next person feel envy of you because they want it, which is what? Covetous, and it makes you feel good that everybody want what you have. All this evilness is what people thrive on than if they was to come across a chosen one. A chosen one is not about that life no more. So I'm trying to tell you all, when you come across a chosen one, you need to thank God, because that individual who God has called could have been the one who broke into your house and killed you and your whole family. That chosen one that's way over there somewhere teaching over there on the west side, secluded, consecrated, could have been the one who was part of a road race by the way you was driving today, could have been the one that cut you off and got out the car and blew your brains out. No, and I'm talking about people who've done these things before they were called. I'm talking about people who've done these things before they were called. Huh? You need to thank them. That chosen one over there in Europe somewhere. They need to thank them. Or you, if we got some Europeans out there, some Europe people out there, you need to thank them. You need to thank God if you come across a chosen one. Could have been the one who kidnapped your kids and killed them, put them on a railroad and killed them. Huh? You need to thank God when you come across a called out one. Could have been the one that took all your money at the tax collection place over there, continued on to steal, and you got enough of them as it is, but you got this one that did it to the bone. He was a beast about stealing all your taxes. You need to thank God when you come across a chosen one who's working on their anger. Before they were called, they were a hothead. Peel your head off if you looked at them wrong. You come across them today, they humble. The list goes on, people. I'm trying to give you a reason for the season to thank God when you come across one of his chosen ones. Let me tell you, somebody say, where Jesus at? Because this world is so hectic, all this killing it. You better thank God when you come across a chosen one, because that's one less murderer you have to worry about. Thank him in the name of Yeshua HaMashiach. I'm trying to tell you something. Y'all not understanding his reason with people. You have to understand God calls his for a reason. His chosen ones is out here serving him for his ultimate purpose for mankind. But yet, people still don't want to understand it. People don't want to believe it. You need to thank God. And I mean, you need to thank God when you come across one of his chosen ones. Because that chosen one, before they were called, could have been the one who was out here being on this killing spree. Huh? And once again, before I close out, I'm talking about those who've done these things before they were called. Shalom.